Hey guys, welcome to another video. This video is going to be on my laciest nigerants, and then I have fed them a fruit fly, so yeah, it is alive. It's currently around, it's in the entrance of the nest, in the white part, and they don't actually know about it yet, and the fruit fly doesn't know. It's actually in great danger by the ants, and fruit fly doesn't know the answer there, but you know, you can see queen in top left, and then there's some larvae and stuff down the bottom, some pupa in the top right. You know, workers are just, oh, it's so tempting, they're just hanging around that top bit. Oh guys, things are happening, I've just realised. It's mainly going off in the tube at the moment. Oh, it's in the white part, it's in the entrance there, so there's not much I can show you. I'm sure that I'll be about to drag it in. The queen's coming to get a bit. Sorry about that, guys. I believe the fruit fly is still in the entrance of the nest, even though it knows there's, well, it's been attacked. That is a much better view. I'm trying to perfect. Oh, fruit flies in the tube now. I think it's trying to get away, but the ant's coming after it. I'll try and get the best. You can see the fruit flies there. Try and get the best view that I can, because that's how long the tube is. It's not really long at all. Oh, there's three ants at the entrance of the nest. And there's quite a few at the entrance. Oh, here we go. I'm trying to show you the entrance of the nest as well. You can't see what's happening. It's really getting on my nerves. Here we go. No. Go the other way. Don't fight at the end of the tube, fight at the entrance of the nest. I need some camera stuff. YouTube. Go on, son. Yeah, there you go, you can sort of see that. Two ants are carrying it now. Trying to. I would do my best to zoom in, but I can't zoom in on that. Won't focus on that. You can see it's all going down now. I'm sorry this video is so... Actually, no, I'll be able to cut it out. My bad. I think I'm going to start bringing it into the nest. Oh crap. Usually when I take that off, the queen goes crazy. Hopefully it'll be alright. So the workers are going a bit crazy. I don't know if that's because of the fruit fly, or because I just took the thing off. This is like the third fruit fly that I've killed. There we go, now we can see it clearly. And clearer. See, the queen's just there, like, with her mantle balls open, antennas moving, making sure nothing's near her. Or the eggs and larvae that are just behind her a bit. There's some ants all around the different spots, so like the eggs and pupa and the larvae, making sure that they're protected. And then the rest of the ants are just going off and one on this fruit fly. And I have been feeding them quite a lot over the past few days. Like, this is the third fruit fly and in like 3 days, plus some honey. So I'm going to slow down the feeding a little bit. Now we can see it all going off. Doing a technique that weaver ants actually do, where they pull the legs of the fruit fly. Oh, watch the larvae. Careful. Yeah, like you can see they're pulling on the legs and stuff. That was it mainly originated from like weaver ants, and then a lot of the other ants evolved to do it. The lava is getting... Oh no, move the lava. That's one of the things why I don't usually feed them live food. Fruit flies are the only thing I feed live. That piece of lava is getting knocked around. Need to move it. You can see just how many ants are up at the top, so I know all the beeper and that. I'm gonna cover them back up because I really don't like it when they're being all covered. Can still see what's going on. Okay guys, so you can watch the rest of that and I'll be back later. See ya. fruit fly. Oh, it's still alive. Alright, I'm gonna leave you guys to watch that. Oh crap. I'm just gonna end the video here, guys, so thanks for watching, I'll see you in the next one.